ditch a sailor.
On December 19, 1919, a new serialized comic strip by Elsie Chrysler Seeger debuted. It was called Thimble Theater. Its cast included the Oil family, mother, Nana Oil, father, Coal Oil, son, Castor Oil, and daughter, Olive Oil, with Olive's boyfriend, Ham Gravy. On January 17, 1929, the cast was taken on an adventure to Dice Island. To get there, Coal Oil and Ham Gravy needed to hire a sailor. Spotting a man by the dock, Castor Oil calls off panel,
"Hey, are you a sailor?
Do you think I'm a cowboy?"
This was the first appearance of Popeye the Sailor. He was so popular with readers that he became a permanent cast member. Max Fleischer had been following this and approached King Features Syndicate about bringing Popeye to the animated screen. Neither King Features nor Paramount thought that such an ugly character could become a successful film star, but Max was confident and secured a license for Popeye in November 1932. For a screen test, Fleischer included him in the Betty Boop series titled simply Popeye the Sailor, which was released on July 14, 1933. And while it was technically a Betty Boop cartoon, it was clearly Popeye's from the start. And the famous theme song composed by Sammy Lerner established the character immediately.
I'm Popeye the Sailor Man. I'm Popeye the Sailor Man. I'm strong to the finish, 'cause I eat my spinach. I'm Popeye the Sailor Man. I'm one tough kazookas, what hates all palookas, what ain't on the up and square. I biffs 'em and buffs 'em, and always outruffs 'em, and none of 'em gets nowhere. If anyone dares to risk my fist, it's buff and it's wham, understand? So keep good behavior, that's your one lifesaver with Popeye the Sailor Man. I'm Popeye the Sailor Man. I'm Popeye the Sailor Man. I'm strong to the finish, 'cause I eats my spinach. I'm Popeye the Sailor Man. Well, blow me down.
The cartoon was such a smash hit that Paramount ordered more. The series began 2 months later and ran 24 years, becoming the most lucrative cartoon series in motion picture history. The original voice for Popeye was provided by novelty recording star William Costello, who was also known as Red Pepper Sam. He used his frog voice for Gus Gorilla on the Betty Boop radio show, and had done some incidental voice work for Fleischer Studios.
Goodbye. Goodbye.
Oh, John, I'll be so lonesome while you're away.
Goodbye, wifey.
Goodbye, John.
Goodbye, John!
Goodbye, John!
But now there was a definite placement for the voice in the Popeye cartoons.
I'm Popeye the Sailor Man. I'm strong to the finish, 'cause I eat me spinach. I'm Popeye the Sailor Man.
From the start, Bluto was the usual source for conflict, which urged Popeye to resolve it through the power of his spinach. With the format established, Popeye moved Fleischer Studios to a new level of story construction and solid characters defined by good voice casting. At first, the Olive Oil voice had an oafish tone provided by Bonnie Poe, who was the voice of Betty Boop in 1933.
Please don't fight tonight, Popeye. You're liable to get hurt. Tell me you won't fight, huh?
If you fight tonight, I'll never see you again. So you won't talk, eh? Goodbye.
Olive's voice was finalized when Max Fleischer asked Mae Questel to try the character.
Oh, sweetheart.
She used an impersonation of comedian Zazu Pitts, and Olive's personality was finally set.
After 20 long years, alone at last.
I beg your pardon, lady.
Oh, dear, we're not alone.
Oh, dear. Here I come.
Ow.
Hello, Popeye.
During the recording session of Be Kind to Aminals, Costello was fired and quickly replaced by Floyd Buckley, who went on to play Popeye on the radio. This obviously was not the best choice.
Stop! Stop that! Stop, I say!
Get up there!
Yeah? Rather me than a dumb Amino.
One day, Lou Fleischer was walking through the studio and heard one of the workers singing in the Popeye voice. He was a godsend. His name was Jack Mercer.
I was in the inking department when I first started to do the voices for the characters I happened to be inking at the time. The other inkers seemed to get a kick out of it and sort of egged me on. After a while, I was advanced to the in-between department, and one day I was given a scene of Popeye to work on. I began to imitate the Popeye voice. I don't know if Dave Fleischer was aware of my potential at this point. I didn't think I did it well enough. Then one day I was informed that I was going to do a Popeye cartoon.
Full bloom and show. Oh, I'm king of the Mardi Gras. I dare anyone to say no.
Oh, I'm Popeye the Sailor Man. I'm Popeye the Sailor Man. I am what I am, and that's all what I am. I'm Popeye the Sailor Man. I'll show you what I did to guys what thinks are tough.
So I felt that Popeye shouldn't be so gruff all the time. I saw him as a kindly type who wouldn't take advantage of his strength against anyone unless he was forced into using it by unfair tactics. He would then eat his spinach and turn the tables on his opponent, who would wind up in a predicament that left him humiliated in a humorous way.
Hey, yo,
and it was Mercer who gave Popeye the personality that made him the character we all love.
Your eyes are like stars. Your lips are like cherries. Your teeth is like poils. Gee whiz, you're the berries.
Oh, Popeye, I think that's wonderful.
The cast was set with a love triangle of Olive Oil, Popeye, and Bluto.
I gotta get rid of that guy.
For the role of Bluto, singer Gus Wickey was the best, with a deep baritone voice that was truly menacing. The Popeye series was a box office champion that outdistanced Mickey Mouse in all-time popularity. In 1936, Popeye hit his peak in his first Technicolor epic, Popeye the Sailor Meets Sinbad the Sailor. This was a first not just because it was in color, but it was the first long format cartoon running 16 minutes.
Give up and up. What are you, a fresh guy or something? I'll show you. I can see. Up. Don't leave me now.
Oh.
gone, my Simba. Who's the most remarkable extraordinary fella?
Sinbad the Sailor was considered for an Academy Award and is considered one of the classics of animation history. From 1933 to 1957, 229 Popeye cartoons were produced for movie theaters. But all will agree that the original 109 cartoons from the Fleischer Studios were the foundation for this longevity, which started 90 years ago, thanks to the vision of Max Fleischer.
Sing along with me, everybody.
I'm Popeye the Sailor Man. Popeye the Sailor Man. I am what I am, and that's all what I am. I'm Popeye the Sailor Man. I'm one tough kazookas, what hates all palookas, what hates on the ups, that's square. Boy, I bips them and mops them and always outrubs them, but none of them gets nowhere. Now if anyone dares to risk my fist, it's bop and it's wham, understand? So keep good behavior, it's your one lifesaver with Popeye the Sailor Man. Oh, I'm Popeye the Sailor Man. I'm Popeye the Sailor Man. I'm strong to the finish, cause I eats me spin.